Today, we will go through the wait function and other methods in Python that are used to tell a computer to wait until a condition is met. But before we do that, please like and subscribe. Multiple operations happen simultaneously in an application to give the user a seamless browsing experience. However, some operations must be paused until an external condition is met, either on the user or the server side. The ongoing operation is delayed for a moment until the external condition is met. So programmers who foresee this eventuality in advance would tweak the program, such as directing it to wait until a specified time. The wait method is used to make a running process wait for another function to complete its execution, such as a child process, before having to return to the parent class or event. This wait method in Python is an OS module method that synchronizes the parent and child processes, implying that the parent will stand in line for the child process to complete its execution. For example, wait until the child process ends before continuing with its execution. The wait method is known as a method of the event class in the Python threading module to release the execution of an event when its internal flag is set to false, which will cause the current block or event to be released until the internal flag is set to true. The wait function is called os.wait in Python, and its syntax is as follows, os.wait. This syntax returns the ID of the child process as a tuple, coupled with a 16-bit number that also appears in the tuple to indicate the exit status. This method returns a 16-bit integer with higher and lower bytes, where the lower byte is represented by the signal number 0, which ends the process, and the higher byte contains the exit status notice. There are no parameters or arguments for the os.wait function. The parent process is suspended or terminated until the child process completes its execution, using the os.wait technique. This wait function is often used to wait for anything to happen in a process, and it will stand in line until the function is invoked true with certain conditions or modes specified. The wait function is defined in two separate modules in Python, the OS module and the threading module. The threading module's event class contains a wait method that suspends the current thread's execution while the event is executed or completed. The OS module accomplishes the same thing, but it collaborates with the parent process to ensure that the child process completes its execution. Let's take a closer look at both of these tactics with some examples. Some criteria necessitate that a Python program waits before continuing. To give the user a better experience, we may need to complete another function or load a file. Now let's discuss some of the examples of how to accomplish this. I have three examples here, two more simple ways and one more advanced. So the first function that we're going to look at is the time module. It's pretty simple. So you want to just wait for the process. So you do some steps, and then at some point you want to wait for something. So for example, if you make an HTTP request, or you're just allowing the user to process something and then you want to continue after a certain amount of time, or you would have maybe a background process running that you know is taking a certain amount of time, after which you only then want to continue with your execution. So as you can look here, I'm importing the time module, and then I'm just printing, you know, starting the process. Then I'm saying time.sleep, and I'm passing in a parameter of 3, which is 3 seconds. And then I'm printing finishing 3 seconds later. So if I execute this now in the terminal, I'm just going to say Python 3 simplewait.py. And as you can see, it says starting process, and then it's waiting for 3 seconds. And after the 3 seconds, it just says finishing 3 seconds later. So this is a very simple example. It's also very often used, this method. So yeah, it's a good option. Now, if you look at the second example, which is using the input method. So this is a native Python method. It'll give you an option to input a value into the console or the terminal. So I'm just saying here, you know, a couple of print statements, then I'm using the input and then another print statement to just visualize what's happening. So if I execute this example, as you can see, it says starting the process, and now it's waiting for the input, and it's asking me to input something. Now, if I don't do anything now and just leave the terminal as is, and I go on my merry way, nothing's going to happen. So the process is going to get to a standstill here. I don't know, there can be some conditions to time it out after a certain time, but it will not, usually, if you don't account for it, time out. So what I'm just going to do is I'm going to input something, for example, a 1 here, and hit the Enter key, and this will then finish the process. So once you've actually inputted something and confirmed it, it will continue. Now, again, this is another simple example if you want to wait for user input. Then a bit more advanced example is what we've mentioned is the os.wait function. And this is about multiple processes in a file, for example. So here I'm referring to child and parent processes. So I am first, so just executing the file will run what is called the parent process. And then if we want to spawn off another process for this, we can use the os.fork method. Which would just fork off a second child processor, and then we just check if there is a process ID for the child, then we're going to wait for the parent to execute. Otherwise, we're going to execute the child process, right? So if I execute this now, you will see that first the child is being processed and then the parent. So if I'm going to go advanced wait, executed, and it says running the parent process, creating the child, executing the child process, and then executing the parent process. So as you can see, the order is slightly reversed, which we want, because we want the child process to finish first, because we might want to process something else. So we want to retrieve some information, or we want to create some artifact first, and then for the actual parent process to finish. I hope that makes waiting in Python a bit more understandable with these three examples. So this was our video on how to wait in Python. And before you leave, like and subscribe.